snakes up out of the low wetlands and up into areas that are safer, like people's homes. That's why I stay in business and stuff just like this. The room with the rabbits is clear, but that still leaves the living room to investigate. Gotcha. Now I gotta check these sofas. Snakes also like to conceal themselves in dark places where they feel the most camouflaged and protected. And a large piece of furniture like a couch is a perfect hiding place.
Don't tell them what I'm gonna find.
Ah, look at all the droppings and the stuffing back here. Oh, got it!
Oh, dude! Oh, man!
Did you pick the wrong place at the wrong time?
Oh, look at him.
Yeah! Oh, watch it there, tough guy.
Can I make a cage up for him?
You want to keep him?
Yeah.
Really?
Well, look at him. He's so friendly.
All right. You never know what you're going to get on a snake call. I turned over the sofa, and I found a mouse up under there. Patricia stepped in and said, look, I love the little furry creatures. I've got a nice little area set up for him.
I got a room for him.
Oh, cool. Well, it looks like Patricia's got another pet, but I'm still concerned that there may be a venomous snake loose in her house. I decided to make one last-ditch effort to look again in the kitchen where Patricia last saw it. Got one more place to check this hot water here.
Okay.
I'd pretty much thrown in the towel, man. I'd given up on it, explained to Patricia, hey, sometimes snakes get away. I thought that's what happened here. That'll be it for today. Okay. As we exited the kitchen, I was wrong.
Oh, whoa!
What?
Oh, see him there?
I see him bounce to life. The snake was under the dog bed she used as a barrier to keep the snake in the kitchen. He must have not been up under your cushion and stepped right over the snake when we got in here. This just goes to show you can never be too careful when dealing with snakes. I stepped right over this guy several times and didn't even see him. And if he's poisonous, that would have been an immediate trip straight to the ER. I immediately noticed the colors were kind of funny, but I started to think, could this be a python?
It looks like a python. No, it's an escaped pet, or somebody's pet escaped, laid eggs, and this is an offspring.
Pythons are not native to America, but people have released these pets for so many years that now we've got about 30,000 wild pythons.
Not gonna bite you, right?
I mean, he could bite. They have sharp teeth, rows of sharp teeth. This one is not poisonous, so don't worry. There's a couple ways of telling. The first way you can tell is by looking at the eyeball. This guy's got a round pupil. It's not slitted. And then on the end here, on the tail, the scales, if they remain in a cross pattern after the anus, it's non-venomous. Even though this snake isn't venomous, it's still very dangerous. Pythons are constrictors who use their powerful muscles to strangle their prey before devouring it. And even though this guy's still a baby, a python can grow to be 23 feet long, big enough to take down a grown man. If you have mice, it might have been in here tracking the mice. People don't realize they buy these little snakes in the pet stores, and then they grow up to be massive snakes, so they release them into the wild. Well, guess what? In the wild, they have babies. Then you have little boas and pythons growing up to be big boas and pythons. In nature, it's not smart. All right, ma'am, I'm gonna go ahead and take him to my truck, and then I'll be right back.
Right, okay? I appreciate it.
All right, yeah. I got him. He's out of here. Patricia was very lucky that python didn't get any bigger. A couple more years out in the wild, and whammo, we got even a more serious problem than we had today. Today, they're just feeding on mice. Tomorrow, it could be your dog.
Slim.
I'll find this guy at home. It's irresponsible to just release the snake back into